More than 65,000 spectators have braved the heat to see the V8 supercars hit the Clipsal track for their first practice session. As drivers prepare for 2 days of racing in scorching temperatures, city businesses are also preparing for a hot weekend of training.
A hot ticket to a hot day of racing.
I just love the V8 cars.
Exhilarating. It's once you get the motors running around the track, there's nothing better.
Getting hydrated, the first pit stop of the day.
It's going to be hot. You want to start early.
We're going to go into the track when the bars open in about an hour.
Thousands ready to welcome the V8s to the track for their first practice session.
Watch the cars go around and introduce my daughter to the Clipsal 500.
I'm looking forward to see what Shane Van Gisbergen's going to do today. Looking forward to the tie-up between him and Wincup.
Drivers preparing for what's undoubtedly set to be a weekend of hot laps.
It's always a tough race, but yeah, you throw that into the mix as well, some extreme heat, and yeah, it's going to be super, super tough.
We have cool suits and helmet fans in the car, so we're prepared for everything, but if one of those fails, it'll be a race ender.
When spectators weren't watching the race, they were watching the skies.
Just the buzz. It's great entertainment.
Clipsal fever has hit off the track too, with local pubs and cafes experiencing a surge in the number of customers.
It's just constant, yeah, from the morning right through till the evening. It's just masses of people just coming through.
Probably planning for a 10 or 20% increase over last year, which was also good.
The first official V8 supercars race begins tomorrow.
Go, Matt, we're the bottom.
Jessica Stanley, Nine News.
On a scorching day, South Australian Scott Pye set the tone with a blistering lap in the first qualifying session at the Clipsal 500. The 26-year-old earned his first pole position for his career, while a returning star showed he's back to his best.
A track temperature of 43 degrees greeted the drivers for the first qualifying session. Jamie Wincup's opening lap not going quite to plan.
Oh no! Oh, that was so close!
Dale Wood cut it fine on the notorious Turn 8 as the soft tyres got a workout. Wincup recovered to record the second fastest lap, but it was a local who took pole for the first race of 2016. Scott Pye setting a blistering pace to earn prime spot on the grid.
It's been a massive off-season. I've got my wish list and it's all coming good, so we've got to keep our head down and work.
Hard tyres replaced soft for the next session, and they proved to be to James Courtney's liking, who set the fourth fastest lap. But it was Chaz Mostert who stole the show. In his first race back from a horrifying crash, he grabbed pole for tomorrow's race too.
Great job. What? Welcome back, mate.
Bit lost for words, can't really describe it. It's an amazing feeling. It feels like my first pole ever again.
Nikki Barnett, Nine News.
It was a great opening to the 2016 V8 Supercar Championship, and we're joined by Dave Reynolds. Dave, a tough day at the office, 16th in first qualifying.
Yeah, it was a very tough day for us, but you know, Adelaide's the hardest track you come to. I've got a new car, a new team, so you know, we've got a bit of a journey ahead of us, but everyone's up for the fight.
Now, I appreciate you joining us, mate. It must have been pretty fatigued, but everyone's talking about Scott Pye's drive. How good was it for the sport, noticing that he's not one of the huge names, but he did really well today?
Yeah, you know, Scott, he's done a fantastic job. You know, anytime you get poles, awesome, but you know, they've got a pretty good program going at Team Penske DJR, and you know, they've got a really good car there, so you know, you'll probably see him up the front a bit more this year, but you know, that's an awesome job by him.
Two races tomorrow in scorching temperatures nearing on 40 degrees. What are your expectations for the opening race in the championship?
Yeah, for myself, my job is just to finish. Like, you know, it's a treacherous track, this one. It's very hard. You know, like I said, it's going to be 60 degrees in cabin temperature, so it's going to be, you know, a really, really tough race. You know, we start 16th to 22nd, so I just want to get through it and hopefully have a better Sunday. You know, it all comes down to qualifying. You really need to qualify better.
Thanks, David. Appreciate you joining us, mate. And go and get some rest. Dave Reynolds there. Meantime, the Taurus Turn 8 has claimed a number of victims today, none bigger than Bryce Forward in the Dunlop Series, the 17-year-old incredibly walking away unharmed after he slammed into the wall at high speeds. Racing was halted for half an hour as they worked to fix the course.